All right, guys, so I went shopping today to get all my stuff for the tamales. So in order, I'm gonna video what I use. So we've got our corn husks. I got three of those. This is basically what I use to make my tamales. So corn husk, I use this pork lard. We got some New Mexico chili. I got a big bag and a little bag, and then I had, and those are hot, and then I already had a bag half full of extra hot. So, because I do might want mine hot. We got the maseca. I got three bags of that. We have the tomatillos. This is going to be for the green tamales. This is, I'm going to make the green salsa. I'm going to use that, the tomatillos. I am going to use onion, garlic, salt, some jalapeno, and some serrano. And then for the cheese, I'm going to use Monterey Jack. I got that one. And then I got Pepper Jack. So I'm going to put cheese in the green ones only. Okay, and then for the meat, here I've got, it already says beef tamale meat. So I got two packs of these. It's pretty, it is a lot. It is a lot. So two packs of those. And then I got three packs of the chicken. So the green is going to be made of chicken. And then this one is chicken legs and thigh meat. So it's pretty much pierna y muslo de pollo sin hueso. And three packs of that. All right, so that is it. Right now we are going to go ahead and put our meat to cook. Here I have the beef. What I did, put in a pot. I added a lot of garlic. It's just hiding there somewhere. I added some onion. I added some laurel, salt, and now we're gonna add some water. So here I have the beef cooking, like I said, with laurel, onion, salt, a lot of garlic, putting up water. Same thing with the chicken. I added the same ingredients. The chicken is going to cook faster than the beef, so just keep an eye on it. So the beef takes about 4 to 5 hours. The chicken, because it is a lot, it may be like an hour or two. So just keep an eye out. So this is just the meat part for the tamales. So while the meat and the chicken is cooking, we're gonna do the green salsa and then the red chili for the tamales. So here what I did, I got a sponge and I put soap and I washed my tomatillos. And then of course we're just gonna rinse them off. Rinse off the soap and I got them in here. And then the serranos, just rinse them off with water. So what I did was I cut off the tips to the serranos. Everything's in here. And I got about 6 serranos. These are hot, but what I'm doing, once I blend these and I'm going to taste for spiciness, if it still needs spice, then I am going to use some jalapenos that I had already cooked and froze. So what I like to do is when they're on sale, I like to bulk it and then I cook it And then I just freeze it, and it's pretty good, like when you're making a salsa or something, just take it out and defrost it, and it's ready to use. So if I need extra to make this more spicy, then I will add it. So here we're going to add our water. We're gonna blend it with garlic and onion once it's done. Okay, so that's gonna be for the chicken green chili tamales. Then we're just gonna put this on the stove, and we're gonna cook it until the tomatillos pretty much get softened and then they turn color. Now for the red chili, what I did is I took off the stems. You can remove the seeds. I tried to remove as much as I could. It's not really necessary because we're gonna blend it anyways. And then what I do, I'm gonna run it under water. I'm gonna get this really clean. And then we're gonna add some more water, and then we're gonna cook it. Once you have rinsed out all the water, add more water. And then what I'm gonna do, I'm going to bring this to a boil. Once it's at a boil, I'm gonna turn off the heat, and I'm gonna cover it and just leave it there for about 20 minutes for it to soften just in the vapor. So once it started boiling, turn off your stove, just cover it, and then we're going to let this pretty much get softened in its vapor. When your tomatillos serranos are already cooked. Now what I did, they already cooked. They are already softened. I'm gonna do it in two parts. I'm gonna throw half of the tomatillos in here and three of the serranos. We're gonna add some salt. I'm gonna add onion and one garlic. And we're gonna add some water, not a lot of water. You kind of want this thick. And then we're gonna blend it. Forgot to add some cilantro. You can add cilantro, you don't have to, but it does give it a little bit more flavor. So let me add the cilantro. The cilantro, I only added a little bit. After you're done blending, just pour it in something, and then I'm gonna do the other part just the same. And here is the green chili for the chicken tamales. So that's it. What I'm gonna do, once the chicken is done, I'm going to shred it, cool it, shred it, put it in like a big bowl, and then I'm going to pour this on the chicken. And then I'm going to pretty much let it marinate all night. So that's that, and now we're gonna do the red. Now for the red, it's all, the pod's already softened. So we are going to blend it with the garlic. Some salt. And some cumin. We're gonna add some water. You can add fresh water, you can add water from where you cooked it. It doesn't matter. Okay, and then we're gonna blend it. Now what I'm gonna do, I got my bowl, I got my strainer, I'm gonna pour it. Here, we're gonna strain it into our bowl. I'm gonna do this with all the chili. And the green and the red is done. Now we're just gonna wait for the meat to cook so we can marinate the red and the green till tomorrow. The chicken is ready. So what I did, I put it in this bowl here. And then I got another bowl, and then I'm throwing a little bit in there. And then I'm gonna put some chili on there. We're gonna mix that in. And then we're just gonna do this again until all the chicken has the sauce. So just do it like that. So what I'm doing, I'm getting this and then I'm throwing it in here, shredding it, and then I'm putting the salsa in here. And this is done. I added the last of the chicken, the last of the chili. I'm just going to mix it all in there. That's it. And then we're just gonna leave it in the fridge overnight and let it marinate by itself. Now for the red, for the beef, what I'm going to do is pretty much the same as the chicken. I just add a little bit. What I did was I took it all out, I let it cool a little bit, and then I shredded it. And then I'm putting it into another bowl, and then I'm going to add some red sauce. Add the chili, mix it. And then we're gonna add some more meat on top and then some more chili. And then just continue to do that until you have all of the beef marinated with the red chili. And now for the husks, what I do is I put it in this pot. I cleaned out this pot. This is where I have cooked the meat. And then I'm going to put hot water in here. You can just do it in the sink too. It doesn't matter. You can, as long as they are in water, I like to add hot water. I'm going to add hot water up to the top. So it has water, has enough water. And then what I'm going to do, I'm just going to leave it in the sink. I'm going to cover it. And then in about a few hours, I'm going to flip them over. So this I'm going to just leave here until tomorrow. Okay, so it's the next day. We have let these marinate. This is the green, the red, and then here is some chili, red chili that I saved for my masa. And here I have the corn husks drying in the sink. So you gotta make sure that they are dry. Now we're gonna start doing the masa part. Okay, so sorry if this video is a little bit dark. It's 5 in the morning and I don't have much light in here, but you're gonna need an olla. We're gonna use 8 cups of this maseca. We're gonna use
tablespoons of baking powder, 2 tablespoons of salt, 3 cups of lard. So right now what we're going to do, we're going to toss out 3 cups of the lard. I also forgot to mention you need 1.5 liters of the juice from where your meat was cooked. So since I cooked it last night, this morning all I did was put it in here and warm it up in the microwave. So it is pretty warm. You don't want it cold. So we're going to set this aside. Okay, I added the manteca in here. It's already it's already like pretty melted. So all I'm gonna do is give it a good whisk with this. But if yours is not melted, like say that you use the lard, the Morel lard or something, then you have to whisk it and make it really smooth. So I'm just gonna give it a quick. That's that for that. And then once that's in there, we're going to toss in our 8 cups of masa, our baking powder, and our salt. I gave it a quick whisk with the whisker, and then I'm just going to get in here with my hands and combine it all together. And then we're gonna start adding our juice. Okay, looks pretty good. Time for the juice. And all you're gonna do is just little by little start throwing the juice in there. And each time you throw it, just make sure it's all incorporated. So once you have all that juice in here and you have already been doing this for 30 minutes, now we can add our red chili. And you can pretty much add however much you want, really. And I just like to add this to give it color. That's it, guys. Then you're red. Tamales are gonna be done here in a minute. Okay, so what you're looking for is just a nice masa, not dry. It has to be pretty kind of soggy type because that's going to give you nice soft tamales. This is probably all I'm gonna add in here. So I'm gonna get this mixed in. And then we're gonna start making the red tamales. Okay, so there's the masa. We've got the red here. That's what we're gonna do. We're gonna save this one because I have to make another batch of masa for this one. So let's get started with the red. Okay, what you're gonna do is get some masa. You can use a spoon if you want. I like to use this, which is my bench scraper. Add as much masa as you want. I like to add just enough, but I do like to add a lot of meat to them. Okay, and then you're gonna get your meat. I'm gonna lay it down there. And then you're gonna close it. Fold it. And one is done. That's it. So just continue doing that with all of them. And then just set them to the side or wherever. And then you're gonna do the same for the green. So have fun, guys. But this is my recipe for my red and green tamales. Ciao.